This task, ito yung magagamit natin yung engineering skills ko. Ang nangyayari is, hinahack talaga yung game. My wife would say na, sobrang kahawig mo, dapat ginanito to eh. Kung ako nandyan, this is what I would have done para manalo agad. Today, we are going to do something very, very different because about a week or two ago, may nagtag sa akin at sinabi nila, Slater, sobrang kahawig mo yung starring ng The Squid Game. So, we got curious, we watched the entire Squid Game, we finished it, nag-marathon kami in like 3 days with my wife, and ang dami kong reactions throughout the game. I drew so many parallels. The whole time I was saying, oh, it's like PBB. Nung nanalo ako ng PBB, parang ito yung feeling. Nung mag-task kami ng PBB, ito rin yung feeling. So, ang dami kong parallels na na-draw. And not only that, ang dami kong mga reaction na, hindi, dapat ganito to para manalo ka ng Squid Game. Kasi sa loob ng PBB house, ang dami kong mga diskarte talaga, guys. Not to toot my own horn, pero I won the most amount of tasks and the most amount of money sa mga tasks namin sa loob ng bahay. Not to mention, I won the entire game. So, ang yabang. But in today's episode, I'd just like to react and like take a tour through memory lane on how sobrang magkapareho talaga sila sa PBB and all my other reactions na dapat ganito to eh. Kung ako nandyan, this is what I would have done para manalo agad. Well, here goes. Wow, Squid Game is number one sa Netflix. Itong scene na to where all the staff are nakamask, very reminiscent of PBB kasi syempre hindi namin dapat makita yung reaction at kung sino yung mga staff ng mga PBB. So tinatawag namin silang ninja. Nakikita nyo naman paminsan sa mga PBB episodes din na may nakamask palagi. So it's something very similar to like this. Okay, first scene, ito yung pinaka sikat, ang daming nag-tag sa akin kasi ito, itong scene na to pag nag-smile siya. This particular scene talaga, I don't know, pareho ba kami talaga ng mukha? Ganyan, ganyan. May time kasi na ganito yung buhok ko when pandemic first started, nung takot pa tayo magpagupit and stuff. My wife would say na, sobrang kahawig mo in certain times, like maybe the eyes or like, I don't know. Comment down below kung magkahawig ba talaga kami. Pero nag-viral talaga to, like it was picked up by mga news channels, mga Inquirer, ABS-CBN, even in the local Cebu News, parang nag-pick up talaga na Slater and yung actor ng Squid Game sobrang magkapareho. So, I see similarities, pero yeah, sige na nga. Itong scene na to, like, it feels like out of this world talaga. Like, itong mga parang maze na ganito. It's not this intense inside PBB, pero ito din yung feeling kasi all the walls are colored brightly, hindi siya yung normal na bahay na colors, and yung feeling is wala ka sa real life. Like, you're talking to cameras all the time, you're talking to, like, people in the sky kasi you're talking to speakers, and parang yung feeling is you're like in an Alice in Wonderland na, or Willy Wonka, Candy Factory na ganyan. It's really like that in PBB kasi bigla na lang dumating yung pagkain nyo or pagising nyo, puno na naman yung ref nyo. May mga ganyang aspect yung PBB din na very surreal, very dreamlike din talaga. Ito siguro si kuya nila. Oh, this scene. This scene talaga, non-stop ko sinasabi kay Chris na, this is so PBB. Kasi they would bring us into an activity center and it's all may painted yung mga walls, so it feels like you're in a different world. Even yung soil, paminsan may soil din talagang nilalagay nila on top of the regular flooring, so it really feels like a different world. Sometimes mukhang farm and merong mga chickens running around. Sometimes, mukhang ibang space naman na parang pang formal event. So, they were really able to transform the space and make you feel like you're in a different world. So, this is very reminiscent of that talaga. Like, sobrang magkapareho. Even yung malaking pintuan na nag-o-open up to bring you into that space. It's crazy the same. Even the doll would be super like swak sa loob ng PBB house. I'm sure all the past housemates can relate na mga ganito, mga creepy things or like things that make you feel uncomfortable. Meron talaga. Siguro for this first game, wala akong masyadong strategy, masishare, but 5 minutes is a long time. I would take my time, I wouldn't run, like I would just walk siguro, but that's it. And it's so easy for me to say because in the movie, na-eliminate sila as in dead. Sa PBB naman, hindi ganyan yung pressure, so you're able to think on your feet pa. I would say, posibleng mag-breakdown ka mentally if like it's life and death talaga. Let's go to the second tasks. I'm actually calling it tasks. Sa PBB task kasi dito challenge. Game pala, game. Ang ganda ng scene na to, guys, because like sobrang kahit nanonood kami like but palagi ko sinasabi kay Chris, wait, may idea ako. Dapat duduraan nila and use that to melt the candy. Tas biglang, oh, he was starting to lick it and he was starting to melt it away. Pero sa akin pa rin, I really feel like my strategy would have been better. So, example, if this was the candy na kailangan nila i-melt yung pattern or remove the pattern, I would like, duraan ko sa likod and I'd use my hand to trace the shape hanggang magme-melt siya. So, that is how I would attack this task. So, wala. Naisip ko lang. So itong scene where they're picking mga team members, they want the strong guys, they don't want the weak old people. This really happened inside the PBB house. We tended to team up with like the big strong guys. So sa amin, I remember si Carlo and si Kuya Eting was the biggest one. One was super parang bodybuilder type guy. And si Kuya Eting, I think, was a construction worker, I think. So he was also very, very strong. So ang nangyari is we always wanted to partner up with them. So it really happens in the PBB. And this one was super relatable talaga. So we never voted them out as much as possible kasi they helped us win the task talaga and get us fed kasi yung premium mga pagkain, di ba? Oh, ito yung marble scene. So itong marble scene na to, they're supposed to compete against each other, even people that they cared about, and parang nag-aaway sila to win the game or to go to the next level para hindi sila patayin. So this reminded me so much of my first task. My first task is when parang sinabihan ako na, Slater, you're supposed to make this girl fall in love with you. Pero itong girl na to, may boyfriend siya sa labas. If not, you will be nominated for eviction. So I actually said, what? First task, like it was the first week of PBB, ma-eliminate na ba ako agad? I couldn't sleep. Parang, sige na nga, gawin ko na nga, task lang naman eh. When I started to do my task, it felt really, really uncomfortable. It was so much against my grain. At naalala ko si Joya, yung nurse namin na housemate. It was a close friend also. I was like, trying to talk to her, trying to like, get close to her, pero parang, it really rubbed me off the wrong way. Sobrang iba yung feeling ko na parang every time I talk to her and like may agenda ako and this would potentially cause relationship problems on her part if I was successful. And sa akin din, I really didn't feel like sobrang pangit to be playing around with someone else's feelings even if it's for a task and for you to win. So that was the first time I said, I'm not doing the task, just nominate me. Hands up ako doon, like parang no. And actually, I think people appreciated that because they voted for me to stay in the game. So I'm very happy I did that. But syempre, kung ganito siguro life in that situation, my decision would have been a different decision. Oh, okay. So with this task, ito yung magagamit natin yung engineering skills ko. Ang nangyayari is, they're supposed to cross a bridge made out of glass. And one is tempered glass, which is stronger, and one is ordinary glass, which is not as strong. And parang you can't identify kung saan talaga ang glass na tempered, diba? So you're like taking a 50-50 risk. So every time you move forward to the next glass panels, the glass sets, you're taking a risk. So if you step on the wrong glass panel, patay ka. So with this one, ang dami ko talagang comments. I don't know if si Chris was irritated at me na kasi ang dami ko, wait, dapat ganito, dapat ganyan. Tempered glass is heat treated. So if it's heat treated, mas marami siyang process na dadadaanan. I wouldn't know from just looking at it up straightforward kung which one is tempered and which one is not. But from the corners, which is makikita natin dito, tempered glass is softer. It's parang mas smooth yung mga corners niya. Kasi nga of those mga extra treatments that it's getting. And while ordinary glass tend to be rougher, sharper sa edge. So makikita yan agad. In real life, tempered glass may tatak sa corner na nakalagay na. Tempered glass. And it's used mostly sa mga big window panels. Ito yung ginagamit namin dito sa bahay. And paminsan, ito din yung ginagamit sa mga tables natin. So if you look at those tables na tempered glass, you would see na smooth siya compared to mga glass sa jalousy. Super sharp yung edges and rough. So paminsan medyo, when you feel it, like, oh, this can cut me talaga. So that's one difference. The other difference here, hinahack talaga yung game eh. The other difference here is sinabi ng isang character dito na nagwo-wobble ng konti yung reflection ng light sa tempered glass, which is actually true, especially for yung mga tempered glass na hindi sobrang high-end. Makikita natin, yung reflection is not the type of reflection that you would see sa mirror. Para siyang may mga warping na makikita. But the whole time, I was saying, now why do they step in the middle of the glass panel? Maybe I wouldn't even need to choose between the tempered and the ordinary glass if I step near the edges of the glass panel. Kasi di ba may beam siya dito? Example, itong hack ko. May beam dito. Ito yung glass panel, remote. If you step in the middle, this is more likely to break. But if you step, maybe you step wide enough or you step towards one side where it's near the beam, baka most likely hindi sila mahuhulog. Wala lang, just a fun fact. But it's an awesome, awesome challenge. It reminds me of the time when we were in PBB na it's always about the discarte you have when it comes to these types of tasks. And that's why we won a lot of tasks because you just have to think outside the box talaga. And I feel like I got that from construction, from engineering, where you're often asked to solve problems that are not on YouTube, hindi mo mare-research, you have to be resourceful. It's that kind of training of analyzing problems and solving problems on the fly. So I feel like that's how na-apply ko lahat ng mga ganyan sa tasks sa PBB. It's just amusing how, I would say, magkamukha nga talaga kami and meron kaming experience na similar na ako galing sa PBB and ito, well, it's a movie but parang siya yung nanalo ng PBB din dito. So, it's a very, very fun trip back to memory lane. It reminded me so much of a lot of things. Even yung control room nila na merong maraming camera angles. Feeling ko, that's what the control room of PBB would look like kasi ang dami nga talagang camera angles, yung mga naka-mask pa, yung naka-black na mask, yung leader nila would be the kuya in PBB. So parang, it was such a fun movie to watch. If you haven't watched this, although nabigyan ko na kayo ng mga konting spoilers, I would highly, highly recommend you check out this movie. It's called Squid Game. It's on Netflix. And yeah, it's a totally different video for us today. If you want more DIY, home design type of things, I'm sure we'll be putting more content out there. So make sure to hit the subscribe button down below. And I'll see you guys later.